guys, welcome back. If you're new to the channel, I'm Mech. If you're a returning viewer, hey. All right, the colorful eye look that you're seeing today, sort of like a peacock kind of look, is in honor of the video that I'm about to make. And this video is a reaction to Angelica Nyqvist. I'm hoping I'm not butchering her last name. She made a reaction video in regard to, well, it's titled Age Won't Stop Me, and it is a reaction video to a young YouTuber, which she did not mention in the video anyway, and I'm assuming it's because she doesn't want this this child to be taunted, but she said it was a younger YouTuber who's not a big YouTuber by any means, and apparently this young lady has said, oh, I wouldn't actually call her a young lady given what she said. This girl said that women of mature age should not be wearing glitter, colorful eyeshadow, or highlighter. Oh, and take this. She has the audacity to say that mature is anyone over 30. Well, I'm not actually offended because to me, maturity is a level of wisdom. It's a state of being. It's you being wiser, and it's maturity is not in terms of age, but like, you know, your, what's the right term? I can't even think of the right term, but it has nothing to do with age. I think maturity is about your outlook in life, you know, essentially not being juvenile. But then so this girl says mature is anybody over 30. In my head, when I think of mature women in terms of age, I always think 50 and up, okay, because to me that is the halfway mark of life. Like, you know, I don't even think 40 is mature. I'm turning 40 soon. I'm 37 years old. I'm 3 years away from being 40, and I don't feel it. And I certainly don't think that I look it. You can correct me if I'm wrong. But yeah, so I'm like, really? Really? Anyway, I just wanted to get on here and react to that. And I remember seeing a comment on Angelica's video saying that, because we are of this age and we have gone through a lot in our lives and have hopefully successfully overcome a lot of struggles and have found ourselves financially, emotionally, mentally, and physically independent, then we get to do whatever the hell we want. And I love that. I love that comment. And I was like thinking, yeah, that's true. When I was in my 20s, I was busy finishing uni. I was busy finding my first job. I was busy building a career that would allow me to afford the lifestyle that I have now. Okay. They say that in your 20s you travel, you see the world and all that. I say, well, actually I did it the other way around. I worked and I built my career and I became a manager quite young, and it was able to travel because of my work as well as live in many different countries. I mean, if you've been following me for a while, I have lived in Doha, in Dubai, in Vietnam, here in Australia. I've lived in Singapore. I've obviously lived in my own country in the Philippines. You know, I've traveled places. I've traveled Asia. I've traveled Europe, right? So, and I don't think that I would have been able to afford that in my 20s, because I'm not really the backpacker type either. So, and no offense to the backpackers, you do you, because I mean, to me, that's really brave, and it's just not something that I think I've got the courage to do. Okay, so anyway, this girl says that we're not allowed to wear glitter, or we shouldn't be wearing glitter. Well, I don't really wear glitter anyway, even when I was younger. And so I assume glitter is associated with fun, parties, and all that stuff. And I'm a granny. I'm a self-confessed granny. I was never a party girl. Even when I was in my 20s, even when I was in my teens, I was in bed by 10 p.m. And that's not because my mother told me to be in bed at 10 p.m. Just because I rise early. I am up when the sun is up. Even now when I'm when on the weekends, I'm not working, I'm up when the sun is up. So I'm like, if I'm up by 7 or 6:30 in the morning, obviously I'll be tired early in the evening. I'll be in bed by 10. Probably won't be sleeping until 11, but at 10 o'clock, I'm in bed. So I'm a self-confessed granny, like I said. And glitter or partying or clubbing was not really my thing, even when I was much, much younger. And even now, I don't wear glitter, mostly because I don't like the look of glitter on my face. And sometimes I do wear contact lenses, so if I wear them on my eyes, there is a possibility that it's going to go in there, and I'm just going to end up in the operating room for an eye surgery, you know? So I just don't wear glitter. But those who do, enjoy it, you know? I mean, don't let anybody tell you what you can do with your life. Don't let anybody tell you what you can put on your own body. And don't let anybody tell you what kind of makeup you can buy with your own money. That's not nobody else's business but yours, okay? What you do with your hard-earned cha-ching is up to you. Now, highlighters. She said stay away from highlighters. I'm assuming because of texture. I've got highlighter on. I don't know if you can see it. I mean, I put a whole lot of highlighter today just because of this video. You can probably see it when I turn my head. Yeah. Look, enjoy highlighter as much as you want. I remember when I was young, in my adolescence, I suffered from acne. And if I've never worn makeup until I was 29 years old, 8 years ago. Didn't wear makeup. When I had to, like, during graduation, I hated it. It felt like I had a mask on, and I just really could not bear the idea of wearing makeup. And I was like, oh, I believe in natural beauty. Whatevs. Anyway, I never wore makeup until I was 29, so, you know, this is my time. I can't afford to buy high-end and drugstore highlighter, and I will put on my face whatever I want to put on my face because it's my face. And it's makeup. You can wash it off at the end of the day. You can take a makeup wipe, remove it, and start all over again. Like, makeup has no rules. Do what you'd want to do. And don't let anybody be telling you what you can and cannot do, because, girl, you can do whatever you want, okay? And what about this, colorful eyeshadows. Why? Why are we not allowed, or why are we discouraged to wear colorful eyeshadow? Colorful eyeshadow is fun. I mean, look at that. It's fun. And whoever said that we're supposed to just stick with neutrals and boring and wearables, I mean, if you like neutrals, go for it. Do it. I happen to be sick of just seeing warm, neutral palettes, cool toned palettes everywhere. I want to wear color, and I will damn wear color. I'll do what I want, because why? It's my makeup, it's my face, it's my body, it's my money. So don't you be telling me that I can't do what I want because I am a woman of a certain age, okay? Honey, 30 is the new 20s. So, maybe you guys can tell me in the comment section down below what you think about this sort of unspoken rule that people of certain age should stay away from certain type of makeup or certain type of clothing for that matter, or fashion statements, you know? Because, I mean, to me, it's something that you can take off. It's not something permanent, you know? And you can change your mind about it. You can wear something today that you like and then hate it the next day and be okay with that, because it just washes off. And clothes, you can change t-shirts, you can change jeans. It's not a permanent thing. So I don't know why there are people out there who feel the need to censor other people, to tell other people what they can and can't do, because, honey, it's none of your business. All right. So, obviously, I'm quite passionate about this topic. So, leave a comment in the comment section down below about what you think about, you know, being told what you can and cannot do, when you're a woman of certain age or certain weight or certain height, or, you know what I mean? Like, you do you, okay? And if you have heard of, like, maybe leave in the comment section down below as well your own experience of being told that you shouldn't be wearing something because you are of a certain age or you are of a certain skin color or you are of a certain body shape. Let me know, okay? And let's make this a discussion, but not, or turn it into a conversation, but not, you know, a debate. Okay, share your experiences. Bye.